So you're looking to start a website and are faced with the decision of what platform should I use? There are many great solutions out there. All will have their pros and cons, but there is one that really is something special. If you haven't guessed it, we're talking about WordPress. Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'd like to welcome you to the Learning Hub. In this video, we're going to jump in and have a look at what makes WordPress such a great choice, no matter the size of your project. Before we touch on what WordPress is, it's worth us taking a moment to understand what it isn't. There can often be a number of misconceptions when it comes to using WordPress, so let's quickly outline a few of these. Number one, WordPress doesn't cost anything. Although WordPress itself is free, there are still a number of things that will add to the cost of getting your website up and running. Number two, every aspect of WordPress is easy to use. Now, getting started with WordPress doesn't take any experience. There are, of course, many facets that make WordPress such a powerful platform to use. And because of this, it allows the more advanced users to take advantage of these deeper features. And the third misconception is self-hosted WordPress and WordPress.com are the same platform. Now, it's important to know they are not the same platform. Although they're built on the same core, they are very different. If all this still sounds a bit confusing, stick with us, as a lot of these points will become crystal clear as this video series progresses. So, let's talk about what WordPress is. WordPress was first released back in 2003. Now, let's be honest, the internet back at this point was pretty much like an awkward teenager, not really sure of itself, scruffy hair, pimples, no dress sense. I'm sure you know what I mean. Since these days, WordPress has evolved to be quite a sophisticated website platform, leading the way with a huge market share of over 40%. Yes, that's right, over 40% of the internet is run on WordPress. Out of the box, WordPress is complete. You can get a website up and running so quickly and easily. Your website will be pretty basic, but it'll work. A huge advantage that WordPress offers at this point, however, is that it is also extendable. This is how you can begin to harness the power of what WordPress brings to the table, easily customizing the look, the feel, and the functionality of your website. And the two most common ways to begin this is through themes and plugins. The theme you choose will dictate a lot of the look and feel of your website. Your theme can also provide additional functionality. There are literally thousands of themes you can choose from, both free and premium, depending on your needs. When it comes to plugins, if you can dream it, there'll be a plugin that can do it. Well, pretty much anyway. All you need to do is search, install, and activate, and you're on your way. As with themes, there are even more plugins available, both free and premium, and this is only the beginning. Let's talk about post types and taxonomies. WordPress comes standard with two main post types, pages and posts. Pages are, generally speaking, used to house your more static content. The main pages of a standard website could be home, about, services, and contact, for example. Posts, on the other hand, are more often than not used for blogs and news articles. The customization I mentioned before comes when you want to create custom post types. This then allows you to create any type of content that has a specific focus. If you were building a training website, you'd create a custom post type to list all of your courses. Or a cooking website might have a recipes custom post type to collate all of its, you guessed it, recipes. WordPress then takes this even further, offering ways to organize, collate, and categorize your content. These are called taxonomies. Say a cooking website wanted to organize all of its recipes into categories such as breakfast, lunch, dinner, dessert, snacks. For this though, we would simply add the categories and then assign each recipe to its respective category. But all of this is super interesting, you say, but how does it compare to the other platforms out there? Many of the available platforms have similarities to some of what we've spoken about, but one of the real defining factors is how much freedom do they actually give you. Many all-in-one platforms try to make it super easy to put together a simple website. The compromise here, however, is that you lose a lot of the ability to customize your website due to the strict layouts and functionalities. Further to this, it is also often difficult to export your content from one of these platforms if you ever want to switch. With WordPress, your content is your content. You can do with it whatever you choose. You can customize the platform until the cows come home. However, it's not advised to hack the core WordPress setup until you truly know what you're doing. All in all, WordPress is such a beautiful system to use. Once you get the hang of it, you'll begin to appreciate the freedom it allows. So I'd encourage you to explore the aspects of WordPress we've discussed in this video. And if you haven't already, join Elementor's vibrant community or check out the Academy and blog. I'm so looking forward to sharing more with you in this series. See you in lesson 2.